Hey everyone, my name is Rosie and welcome back to my channel. I have been obsessed with miniature things lately. They're just so cute and tiny and I just am so in love with all of them. So I wanted to make a tiny little art journal for us today that we could fill with really tiny collages. And so I did already make the journal, but we'll go back and look at how I made that. And then also we will make some tiny collages to fill it up. And I really hope it looks as cute as it does in my head because I'm very excited to see this come together. So let's get into it. So I had a very loose plan going into this. I knew I wanted this journal to be small, but not too small. Making really tiny collages is almost impossible. So I still wanted it to be small enough to be very cute and adorable, but manageable to make a collage in. So I sort of just picked the size of paper that I thought felt right. So we're going to fold each of the pieces of paper in half, and then we'll nestle the three folded pieces of paper together to make a signature. And then we're going to sew everything together. We're going to actually bind this little journal, make it look really official. And because I'm using three pieces of paper together, at the end, I'll have in my journal 12 pages, individual pages, that I'll have to fill with collages. I felt that felt like a good number. It wasn't too many where it was super overwhelming to finish in one video, but it was enough to make sort of a substantial journal at the end of it. And once I had my pages cut out and that size figured out, I could make the cover sort of just a little bit larger than the pages. So it overhangs on all of the edges, which I think is kind of a nice look. And I'm using a just sort of a leather scrap that I had. And so once we have all our pages cut out and our cover cut out, I made a template to punch the holes in the pages and in the cover. And I'm using an awl to punch 4 holes so we can bind and stitch the book together. And I'm using this template so that all the holes are in the right spot and they'll line up when we go to sew everything together. So once all my holes were punched out, it was time to start sewing. I ended up using just normal embroidery floss. It's just what I had on hand. And I did a pretty normal stitch. I only had 4 holes, so I started in one of the center holes from the inside of the journal so I could hide the end of my floss inside of the journal. Then I went in through with the edge hole that was next to the one I went out of. And then I went all the way up to the other end of the journal, went out through that top hole, and then I went back in on the last hole in the middle. And then we tie up our loose ends and we have a very close to finished journal. And I hope all of that made sense. And the very last step is to cut a very thin piece of the leather, and then we can make a little tie that we can tie the journal shut with. And I stuck the tie to the journal with just a little bit of super glue. I bet there's a fancier way you can do this where we could have, you know, sewed it in with the stitching, but the super glue works just fine. We just gotta wait for that to dry, and then it's all ready to start filling up with art. And now begins the hunt of finding every tiny image I possibly can. I did find these sort of encyclopedias pretty good for small images because, you know, they put little decorative images alongside text and things. So I was able to pull a lot of very small animals from this book. That was really great. But I really wasn't concerned about what I was pulling out. I just basically pulled out every image that I could find that was small enough to fit on the page of the journal. So I've collected a whole bunch of little images here that I'm hoping we can sort of maybe merge together to make some spreads in our little collage journal. So I'm gonna kind of just poke around and sort of see what things we could merge together. It might be fun if we could take this cat and maybe the cat is balancing on this airplane, and that might be a fun pair. I was also thinking this hand holding this cards, maybe we could put an image in each of the cards and have that be sort of a fun little deck or something. Maybe I can use this clownfish picture and cut it to the size of the card and have the fish maybe coming out of the card a little bit. So one of the cards in the hand is this underwater scene. I kind of like that idea, might work. And maybe the computer, we could have something coming out of the computer, like maybe this fish. Oh, maybe the rocket ship is coming out of the computer screen. That might be a fun combo. I really loved how small this elephant was, because it's sort of like the giant, most giant animal on the planet is the most smallest picture. So I definitely want to try to use that because he's just so cute. Maybe I take this penny and replace the snail shell with a penny. Maybe. Or maybe an acorn is the snail shell. It's kind of the right size. It's cute. And I have two snails and multiple acorns, so maybe they go together. I feel like I have some good ideas, so let's take some of this off to the side and see what we have so far, get some stuff cut out and start putting it in the journal, and we'll see where we're at. I'm not sure I can cut around that mouse. This is really small, so I think it's just gotta go. I don't know. I don't think I have the patience for that. Even though everything was so incredibly tiny and really hard to work with, this entire process was so fun because it was really relaxing just to make odd pairs. Because the pieces were so small, I decided to keep things really simple and for the most part just pair two objects together. And so it was fun just sort of playing around with the pile of images that I had and seeing what two weird things can we add together next? Having this piece of corn being held up by this lady is just silly, and I really love it. And yes, they're simple, but they're so small. Together, when we have the whole journal come together, it'll just be a really fun set, and the entire journal will be super cohesive and super simple. And this process was just so fun.
for some reason, I thought it was going to be a funny idea if I cut this fish in half and try to make it look like the fish is swimming through a penny. And in my head, this sounded like a really good idea, but when I put it all together, it didn't quite look that right. And I had already cut the fish in half. So instead, I put the fish with this man. So it looked like the man was carrying this giant fish on his shoulder. And I think that was a much better pairing. And I was still able to save this fish I had cut in half. Also, throughout this process, I had been thinking about how I could make some of the pages maybe play together and make a more cohesive spread. And so this guy, when I saw his legs hanging off the edge of the page, I thought, well, let's borrow those and put them on the other side and sort of make these two pages work together as more of a cohesive set. And here's our completed, adorable mini collage journal. I am the biggest fan of this thing. It's so cute before you even open it. And then you're greeted by this weird volcano who's saying hi to you. And that is the perfect way to intro this journal, because each page just has a wacky pairing, a wacky little collage. And it's just so fun to flip through because you never know what quite is going to be on the next page. And I tried to pair some of them together. Like, these are both space themed. I thought they worked well together. And a lot of them have fun animals. And this entire process was so fun to put together. And I'm so glad we have a completed journal to flip through today. And I don't even know what to say anymore because I'm just so happy with how this turned out. So I hope you all enjoyed this video, enjoyed watching this entire collage journal come together, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!